हेलो, गुड इवनिंग स्टूडेंट्स. दिस इज़ पीके सर, केमिस्ट्री सर. वेलकम यू टू द सेकंड पार्ट ऑफ द चैप्टर सॉल्यूशन ऑफ क्लास 12th केमिस्ट्री. स्टूडेंट्स, इन द प्रीवियस पार्ट वी हैव डिस्कस्ड मेनी थिंग्स. सो आई रिक्वेस्ट यू टू जस्ट विजिट अगेन दैट पोर्शन. That is very helpful for the understanding of this part as well as later part. So let's start today. Today we are starting with the term concentration. This is very important term. Very important term. Not only for CBSE exam purpose but also for competitive exams. Meanwhile, I will be discussing many questions also which are related with this term, that is the part of previous year's question paper from board exams as well as competitive exams. Okay, now see, first of all, about concentration, it is not a new term for you. It is, you are very well familiar with this term concentration. I think in class 9th you have discussed with your teachers, so it's not a new term. Still, we need to once a quick look that what is the meaning of concentration, what is the meaning, what is the meaning of this term. In short, I will be using in this way, concentration. Concentration in this chapter, I will be using in this way hereafter, okay? Now, before proceeding for the meaning of concentration, I have three words which are very important words which you should know, or maybe most of you are well known for these words. The three words are solution, already we have discussed, solute, this one also we have discussed, and solvent. These are the three words you should know about, and you must have idea about these three words. Okay, these are very important words. Now, what is the meaning of solute? What is the meaning of solvent? Solute means the component of a solution. The component of a solution which is present in small quantity. Small quantity. That is called solute. It is obvious that what about solvent? It is larger. Okay, when solute and solvent are mixed, then they form another thing, that is solution. So before proceeding for the meaning of concentration, we should know about solution, solute and solvent. Okay, now what is the meaning of concentration? Students, for concentration we have two methods, means there are two types of way by which we can express the concentration. One is qualitatively and second one is quantitatively. Qualitatively and another one is quantitatively. Qualitatively also two types which are very well known to you, because in class 11th we have discussed many times qualitatively. When we say a solution is qualitatively, the concentration unit of a solution qualitatively, then that time we mean two words. One is dilute and another is concentrated. Dilute and concentrated. Now, what is the meaning of dilute and what is the meaning of concentrated? You should know. Although we have discussed in your previous class, but still we need to know if you have no idea. Okay. So, dilute means what? Just I am giving one example to better understand this concept of dilute and concentrate solution. Okay, here I have two beaker or two container. In both container I have 100 ml water. Okay, in both container the quantity of water is equal, that is 100 ml. Okay, now in this container, okay, let us say B container and this one is A container. In B container I have mixed 5 gram of salt, and in this container I have mixed 2.5 gram of salt. Now after dissolving, of course one solution is prepared, all of you know. Now what is the difference between these two solution, means the solution which is present in beaker A and the solution which is present in beaker B? The solution which contains, important definition, the solution which contains lesser amount of solute comparatively, see here 2.5 gram, here 5 gram. So the solution which contains lesser amount of solute is known as dilute solution, and the solution which contains more amount of solute, that is called concentrated solution. It is not always that we take this amount of solute in gram, we can take in liter or milliliter, means that is volume also. Okay, so this concept is called qualitatively concept, or qualitatively the way. Qualitatively we can say that as concentration may be dilute concentration or dilute concentration and concentrated concentration. Okay, now what is the meaning of quantitatively? Quantitatively, now if we say, why do we need this quantitatively concentration? The problem is that if we say a solution is dilute solution, can we understand that what is the amount of solute in this solution? Or if we say that a solution is a concentrated solution, then do we understand, can we understand that what is the amount of solute in this solution? So to remove this confusion and to say the exact amount, we need the quantitative concept of concentration. Okay, now in quantitative concept also there are mainly three types. Here I am saying there are mainly three types, so this one I am taking here. There are mainly three types. The first one is mass percentage. Okay, second one is mass by volume percentage, and the third one is volume by volume percentage. These are the three types of quantitative concept of concentration. Okay, now in detail we will be discussing one by one. First is mass by mass percentage. Mass by mass percentage, what is the meaning of mass by mass percentage? We know that a solution contains minimum two components. So if we want to say mass percentage of a component, here it is represented by WYW. This is represented by mass by volume is represented by W by V percentage, and this volume by volume is represented by volume by volume percentage. Okay, this is important, you should know. Okay, next. Now what is the meaning of mass divided by mass percentage? Example, or just how to define mass percentage. Mass percentage can be defined mass of component in the solution upon total mass. Now I am saying that any solution have minimum two component. So if we want to calculate mass percent of one component, then mass of that component divided by total mass of that solution. Okay, now important thing is that it is unitless. This concentration is unitless. This is important. In exams you should know the units also, because sometime it will be helpful in numerical questions. Okay, next, mass by volume percentage. Now what is the meaning of mass by volume percentage? Nothing important, just only that here in this unit, here we can say that mass of solute divided by total volume of solution, that is called into 100 and then percentage. So this is called mass by volume. First one is mass by mass percentage, second one is mass by volume percentage. Okay, here also 100 is there, 100 multiply. Okay, now what is the meaning of volume by volume? The same thing, volume by volume means volume of solute divided by total volume of solution. This is called volume by volume percentage and into 100. Okay, now this is the broader classification of quantitative aspect of concentration. Now here what is important for us is examples. Mass by mass percentage, what is the meaning of this mass by mass percentage? What are the examples which we use here? First example is molality. I think all of you have heard this word molality in previous class, which is denoted by small m. Student, it is very important, the notation of molality is small m. Next one is ppm, parts per million. This is also calculated as mass by mass percentage. First one molality, second ppm, third one is very important, that is mole fraction. Mole fraction is denoted by this symbol x. Okay, so these are the examples of this category. Okay, mass by volume percentage, very important. What are the examples here? First example is very well known, molarity molarity and that is denoted by capital M, molarity. And second example is normality, which is denoted by capital N. Both of them are very important for us in exams, that is board exam as well as competitive exams. These are questions are asked frequently based on these two concepts. Okay, and there is no particular example for this volume by volume percentage. Now sometime, although it is not asked, but sometime it may be asked that which of the following is used in which area of the life, which field of the life. So that is important for us. Okay, after this one we come to the examples, because our purpose is to attend the numerical questions also. Example number one, if I say a solution, a solution is 10% solution, of salt by mass. Explain what is the meaning of this statement. A solution is 10% solution of salt, 10% solution of salt by mass. What is the meaning of this one? Nothing, it is very easy. Just you see, we have discussed mass percentage. What is mass percentage? That 10 gram of solute, here in case salt, and if you are saying a solution, then surely it is dissolved in water. Now total is 100%, so remaining part is 90 gram of water. Okay, so total is, this is the meaning of this one, that a solution is total 100 gram, total 100 gram, in that total 100 gram, 10 gram is solute, that is salt, that's why this solution is called 10% by mass. Okay, 10% by mass, very easy example, you should know. Now what is the use of this one in the life, in the daily life? Commercially bleaching solutions are sold, commercially, example, what is this called? Daily life example. Bleaching solution. Commercially, bleaching solution contains how much by mass? 3.62% by mass. This is the example in daily life. Now what is the meaning of this one? Important thing is that what is the component in bleaching solution? Sodium hypochlorite, which is very famous nowadays. Sodium hypochlorite, which is very popular nowadays in news because of coronavirus, the liquid which is used to spray here and there, that is containing sodium hypochlorite, which have disinfectant properties, sodium hypochlorite. Comment में all of you say in comment what is the formula. All of you type in comment what is the formula of this sodium hypochlorite in comment. Okay. So this is the daily life example of mass percentage. Now what next one is example of volume percentage. Very important, that is also. This is the first example. Okay. Second example of daily life is one important thing is antifreeze. What is the meaning of antifreeze? All of you know about vehicles, car, buses, trucks, they have radiator. In radiator, water is used. In radiator, water is used, and during winter, when temperature approaches 0 degree or below, then that time what happens? What is the use? What is the role of this water? Just it maintains the temperature and does not allow the that petrol to freeze. So antifreeze. Okay. Now, during winter, the temperature approaches 0 or below. In that case, what happens? Water will not perform its function. Now, this problem is very common in those countries where temperature during winter is very low. Okay. Now what is the solution? One chemical is there that is called ethylene glycol. Ethylene glycol. Okay, I am telling the formula. CH2OH. This is called ethylene glycol. Okay. In comment tell what is the molar mass. What is the molar mass of this compound? Now, in these countries, what is the solution of this problem? That during summer temperature is very less and then water becomes ice. Because of that, water is not able to perform its cooling property function. Now, this ethylene glycol is mixed in water. This ethylene glycol is mixed in water. How much ethylene glycol is mixed, that is important for us. That is called 35% volume by volume. What is the meaning of this one? If you have 100 ml of If you have 100 ml of solution, out of that 35 ml is ethylene glycol. So this is called 35% by volume. Now what is the role of this ethylene glycol? Because of adding of this ethylene glycol, lowers the freezing point of water. What is the freezing point of water? 0 degree centigrade. 0 degree Celsius or 0 degree centigrade. It lowers the temperature. And up to what? It lowers the temperature up to -17.5 degree C. Now what is the meaning of this one? Means up to this temperature, water will not freeze, water will not become ice. So the problem of this is solved. That is why it is called antifreeze. Now question is asked simply in board exams that what do you mean by antifreeze, or it may be simply asked is why do ethylene glycol is mixed in water in radiator of engines, like that question may be asked. So this is very important. Next example for 3. दैट इज फॉर PPM, फॉर PPM. नाउ अबाउट फर्स्ट वन एंड सेकेंड वन वी हैव डिस्कस्ड द फॉर्मूला और हाउ टू एक्सप्रेस दिस वन, बट PPM वी हैव नॉट डिस्कस्ड. ओके, सो यू शुड नो वॉट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ PPM. PPM मीन्स मिलियन, पार्ट्स पर मिलियन. इन वन मिलियन हाउ मेनी पार्ट्स आर देयर ऑफ वन कॉम्पोनेंट, पार्ट्स ऑफ फर्स्ट कॉम्पोनेंट, पार्ट्स ऑफ कॉम्पोनेंट अपॉन टोटल पार्ट्स ऑफ दैट सॉल्यूशन. ओके, एंड इफ इट इज मल्टीप्लाइड बाई 10^6, देन वट एवर वी गेट द आंसर दैट यूनिट बिकम्स PPM. ओके, पार्ट्स ऑफ कॉम्पोनेंट डिवाइडेड बाई टोटल पार्ट्स ऑफ दैट सॉल्यूशन. ओके, ऑल कॉम्पोनेंट्स ऑफ दैट सॉल्यूशन एंड दैट इज मल्टीप्लाइड बाई 10^6. दिस 10^6 इज 1,000,000. ओके, सो द यूनिट बिकम्स PPM. Now what is the use of this PPM in daily life, that is important for us. First example is the concentration of oxygen in seawater is denoted by this. For example, this is 5.8 PPM. The concentration of oxygen in seawater is 5 PPM. Can you explain it, this one, how 5.8 PPM means? Here it is 5.8, let us say 5 gram, 5.8 gram of oxygen is present in one into 10^6 gram of water, 10^6 gram of water. So this is called 5.8 gram aquatic life. That is oxygen important for aquatic life, that sustains the aquatic life. Okay, next one more important thing is that pollution, when we are talking about any pollutant, that time also the concentration of pollutants is denoted in PPM, or this is called microgram per milliliter. This is microgram per ml. PPM you can say, or you can say microgram per ml. So this is also the use of this PPM. So that is the end of the video. Again, I request you to make your own notes for the exam perspective, exam purpose. It will help you a lot, and keep revising the previous chapter, previous topics, to increase your memorizing power, to increase your command over the chapter. Till then, take care. Bye-bye.